Now, let's add ability for users to log in. Again, we start by adding in the route. Login. This will be /login-controller.show-login-form. Then route.post. This should be login /login-controller.login. Give it the name of login as well. Next, let's create the login controller. I don't need make controller /login --type equals to HTTP. Then let's add in our methods. The first method is show login form. Then we'll pass in the view. Return view dot random out dot login. Next, let's create the login view to be inside the auth folder. Login dot edge. This will be similar to the register view. So we'll copy the code and paste it in. This should be login. This should be to the login route. Then we'll take out the username field. Then we'll take this one out. Then the value and this. We'll do the same thing for the password. Then we'll add in one more field, which will be the remember me checkbox. Then label dot checkbox. The input checkbox. The name will be remember. And the label will be remember me. Lastly, we will update the button. It should be login. Now we should be able to see our login form. Now let's add in the login method. It will be an async function. Login. Then we'll pass in the request auth section and response. First, to get the form data. Then we retrieve user based on the form data. If a user is found, we verify the user password. Then if the password is verified, we log in the user. So let's get the form data. Be email, password, and remember. Be request dot all Because you'll be querying the database for not just the email and password fields. So using the auth attempt method won't work. So we need to create our own custom query.
Const user.query.where email is equal to email and where is active. It's true. Then we need to pull in the user model. Use app/models/user.
So what we are doing here is that we are querying the database for where the email address matches the one the user provided and where his active is true. That means the user has confirmed his or her email address. Next, we verify the user password. So if user is found, we verify the user password. Password verified. Await #verify.
Verify the password the user entered with the one in the database. Let's put in the #provider. If the password is verified, we log in the user. Await auth dot remember. Then we'll cast this to boolean. Then login. Passing the user object. Then we redirect to the home route.
What we are doing here is that if the user has checked the remember me box, we remember the user and log them in. If not, we just log them in. So that is why we are casting the remember me value to boolean. If the user checked the remember me box, this will be true, otherwise it will be false. If a user is not found, we display an error message.
section.flash.notification. Then the type will be danger and the message will be we couldn't verify your credentials. Make sure you have confirmed your email address. Then we will direct back.
To test this out, let's quickly create a new user.
We'll call this Jane Doe @example.com. Register. So let's try logging in with this new user. Gender. As you can see, because this user has not confirmed his or her email address, the user is not allowed to log in. Now let's try logging in as the first user we created, which has already confirmed his email address. John Doe. Then check to remember. As you can see, the user is logged in and redirected to the home route. Now if we inspect our database and check the tokens table, we'll see that a new token has been inserted. This is as a result of checking the remember me box. As you can see, the token is of remember_token. That is it for this video. In the next video, we'll be looking at how to reset password. Kindly subscribe to be notified once new videos are added. If you have any questions or comments, kindly drop them in the comment box below the videos. See you guys, and thanks for watching.